Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will do some actual scanning, and for that I have picked a domain outside of my local area network. You can find this on the Nmap official site, so it's scanme.nmap.org. This domain they have given, and you can feel free to scan it. Well, not as much as you wish, because you know 100 times a day is not okay, but a couple of times a day is okay, and you can test out whether your Nmap works and how it works. So I need to take this domain. You cannot use Control-C or Control-V in the terminal, primarily because Control-C is the universal interrupt and Control-V will simply not work. You will need to use a mouse and manually do it. In any case, we need to trim this down. We don't need any of these things. We just want the domain name to remain. And now I'm going to go ahead and type in nmap space. And there we go. We're going to now scan this domain. However, if I just press enter like this, it's going to conduct some scanning. It will do the job, I assure you. But it will give us no output of whatsoever. So this will be continuously empty until the scan is actually complete. Now, on short scans such as these, that's probably okay. But if you're conducting a scan that can last up to a day or something of a kind, it's pretty worrying to see that there is nothing here. I mean, you're not sure whether it's working, is it bugged or whatnot. That's why it is always better to pass a V option for verbose output. I have a preference to pass a double V option for extra verbose output, pretty much. So it tells me pretty much everything that it is doing and how it is functioning, and I can see it as it goes on. And I can see that some ports are open a little bit earlier prior to the completion of the scan. I'll just go ahead and start the scan, and you can see immediately before it finished the scan, it has told me that the port 22 and the port 80 are open. Now, by default, Nmap will scan for 1,000 ports. You can tell it to scan for more ports, no problems. You can tell it to scan for the maximum range of ports. It's 65,000 something. I'm not exactly sure what the end number is, but it's 65,000 something. And you can find this on the net if you wish. You can specify, you can pass an option to Nmap to do a full port scan, so all of the ports will be scanned. Although rarely anybody does that, it's time consuming. Usually you have an idea of what sort of services you want to target, and then you scan for those, for the ports on which those services are likely to run. For example, port 22, that would be SSH. And port 25, that's SMTP. If you don't know what that is, it's a mail server. 80 HTTP, and you have a ping echo as well on port 9929. And now the states of these ports are rather clear, so it's open, 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 and you can also get a state closed because it says here not shown. 996 ports closed, they are closed. And when it says filtered, well, usually there's a firewall setting which is dropping the packets. It's not closing the port perhaps, but it's definitely doing something to the packets coming on that port. It's perhaps blocking them from a certain IP or something of a kind. There can be a lot of options here. In any case, the general meaning of this filtered flag here is that the Nmap cannot determine whether the port is open or closed. Usually you want to stay away from those ports, or you can do some extra research and find out how you can access them. Maybe they require a particular app or a particular protocol or something of a kind to be accessed, and that's why Nmap cannot actually figure pretty much anything out of it. That can be a bit problematic. I would definitely, as I said, advise to stay away from them. Stick to the open ones and see what you can do with the open ports here. Now, Nmap also has a option to create graphable output. Basically what that means is that you can sort whatever result you get into a file. You can store it and sort it as well, and then what you gain an ability to actually extract pretty much separate bits and pieces of information. For example, you just want the IP addresses of hosts that are up, or you want the IP addresses of hosts that have port 22 open or filtered, or that are running a certain service like SSH or SMTP or HTTP or something of a kind. However, I won't be doing that for scanme.nmap.org. I believe I have used their system enough. And for this example, I require a range of IP addresses to give you a meaningful result. So what I'm going to do is scan my local subnet, and if you don't know what yours is, well, it's most likely configured as mine is, but if it's not, just type in, let's just clear the screen first, type in ifconfig, and you will get a result here for ETH0 or for whatever interface you are using. Just take a look at this IP address that has been assigned to this interface. So the lowest and the maximum value of the final octet here, or the first octet here, will be the range of your local subnet. So from 0 to 255. Let me just show you how that looks like in case you did not understand here. Type in nmap, and then for a graphical output we need OG space dash, and then we need to give it a range of IP addresses. So 192.168.1.0-255. So it's going to scan for all the IP addresses that have this and that go from 0 to 255. Now keep in mind that I can customize this range any way I want. For example, here where it says 1, I can type in dash 267. So it's going to use this octet and this octet in combination, and it's going to scan for all possibilities, although that might take a lot of time because that's a lot of IP addresses. Anyway, I'm not just done yet. What I need to do is actually cause a redirect. So before I cause a redirect, I'm just going to give it a double verbosity mode. And why am I redirecting my standard output? Well, I don't want all the information to just be printed out on the screen, on the terminal screen, where eventually it will be lost pretty much as soon as I close the terminal or as soon as enough commands are passed that the cache needs to be rewritten for the terminal or something of a kind. Furthermore, if it's written out in standard output and on the terminal itself, I can't do anything else with it. I cannot manipulate it. It's not a file that I can take or something of a kind. Rather, instead, it's just standard output. What I want to do is cause a redirect with a greater than sign into some sort of file. So I'm just going to go ahead and type in home, and not desktop, that's not a good idea. Let's just leave it at home, that's better. And I'm gonna name this file scan. Excellent. So all the results that Nmap gathers now will be stored into this file here, with the path, and this is the path to the file. Now, since I have passed a good amount of hosts here, I mean, I've given it 255 hosts, because I'm in LAN, it's going to go faster, but when you're doing this over the internet, a very good idea is to pass a port, or at least a port range. Don't let it scan all 1,000 ports, or even worse, do not specify that it should scan a full port range, primarily because regardless of what sort of internet connection you have, it will take a good amount of time to finish. Furthermore, you're bound to trigger some red flags or something of a kind, so you should define a port here in order to save yourself a lot of time. And I mean, generally, you will know which service you want to attack. You will have some sort of an idea there. I'm going to go ahead and pass port 22. That is the port that I wish to scan for. And press enter and hope to God that it works. There we go. It is functioning, but it finished rather fast. But even though I passed the double verbosity mode, everything here is being redirected here. So I will see nothing. If this scan takes longer when you're doing it over the internet, and it will take longer if you're doing it over the internet, don't think immediately that something is bugged, primarily just because nothing is being written down below. If we just change to home and list what is there, there we go, we have the scan. So let's just do this, ls. Now look what I'm doing here. I'm going to do a very similar thing with our scan file, and I'm going to type in grep scan, press enter, there we go. I have passed the ls command to list pretty much everything within the home directory, and then I have piped the output of ls to grep. Basically pipe means just pass it. I've passed the output to grep, and what grep does is basically pull whatever you specify here. It just pulls it from the output. I've told it to pull whatever is in there that has a name scan, or that has a string scan within it. So I could have had a name like AAA scan BBB. It would still pull it, no problems. This is one of the ways in which you can make sure that the file is located within a certain folder, especially in situations where you have hundreds of files in a single folder and you just can't go through them all manually. Use a grep if you know the name, or if you know a partial name, in order to figure out what is where. So I'll just go ahead and clear the screen, and let me just show you what is located within our scan file. So less scan, press enter. And there we go. So we have pretty much all the hosts within my LAN network, within my local subnet. They're all down, of course, because I don't have 255 computers or devices within my home network. Rather instead, you see what it has found. It has found, this is the router IP, the router that I'm using for this test. And it says port 22 filtered TCP SSH, excellent. That one has an open port of 22. Also, its status is up. And I also have on 100, status is up, 22 is closed. On 102, it's up, it's filtered, and so on and so forth. So let me just go ahead and quit this, and I'm gonna do a very similar thing here because I want to leave it on the screen so I can explain it to you. The less command is very nice, but when you exit, it disappears. Cat, however, just prints everything within a file to standard output, and it stays here, pretty much for the duration of the terminal. The reason why I did this will become apparent quite soon. So what you want to do now is type in cat scan as before, and now we want to pipe the output of scan to grep in order to pull something out of here, some sort of useful information. Let's say that I want to pull all the hosts that are up. I want to pull all live hosts. I want to see their IP addresses. And when I type in grep, what is the universal markation for all the hosts that are up? Well, you have a flag here, next status, and then flag up. Let's just go ahead and type in up. Press enter. Excellent. Just to give you a bit of clarity, there we go. You have these flags which are up, so I have all the hosts here that are currently up and running, that are alive on the network. But this is not what I want. If I wanted to pass these IP addresses to a program, to another program or something of a kind, I wouldn't be able to pass this whole line because it would make no sense if the other program is requesting only the IP address of the host. Because you can do one Nmap scan to see which hosts are alive, and then once you've figured out which hosts are alive, then you can do a more detailed scan on those particular hosts, and in such a way you would save a lot of time. So we have these hosts here, but we want to pull these IP addresses, and I'm afraid I just can't do that with grep. Perhaps I even could, but I mean it would just be too complicated and too complex, and it really wouldn't be practical. That is why Linux has something that is called awk. So AWK, it's a basically used for formatting text and pulling out certain parts of a file that you have deemed that you need or something of a kind. Now, you can make a separate tutorial on awk. You can have hundreds of hours, and there would still be features of it that you would not know. I would strongly advise you to familiarize yourselves with awk. Take a look at the man pages for awk. However, for the time being, and for the purposes of this tutorial, we will be using some basic awk commands, which pretty much everybody uses, and which are a necessary part of pen testing, primarily because you need to do stuff of a kind that we're going to do here. So cat scan, print everything to standard output, grep up, so grep all, oops, grep all lines that contain the word up. And then what I want to do here is eliminate this part, leave this part in, and eliminate this part. So how shall I do that? Well, the first thing that we need to specify is a field delimiter. What a field delimiter is, basically, if you say that the colon here is a field delimiter, this will be one field, this will be another field, and this will be yet another field. So you will have three fields in total. However, that doesn't really work for us, does it? Because if we say that the colon is a delimiter, this entire section that I've highlighted will be considered a field, and we will have parentheses and status, the parts that we don't really want. What you can use as a field delimiter here is a space. So space here, this is one field, this is going to be another, and this is going to be again a field delimiter because there's a space, and this will be a third one, and then you have again space and the fourth one, and so on and so forth. So in order to specify a field delimiter to be space, well, simply leave an empty space in between the quotation marks. Generally, you would put quotation marks and you would specify a field delimiter in between them. If you wanted a colon, this is how you would do it. But we don't want a colon, we just want a space, and that's it. Open single quotation marks, open curly brackets, type in print space dollar sign, and then you just need to type in the number of the field that you would like to print out. So we would like to print out the second field. Two, close curly brackets, close quotation marks, press enter, and there we go. We have all the IP addresses listed of the hosts that are up without anything else. Now what you can do with this is, well, pass it to another file. It's called scan2, press enter, and then you can type in nmap-il scan2. Then you can do a full nmap scan for just four hosts. This might take a bit of, I don't want to do it like that. Let me just give it a double verbosity mode. Excellent. So now you can do a full scan for just four hosts instead of doing it for all 255 hosts. Just figure out which hosts are alive, and you don't need to do that with port 22 or something of a kind. Just do a ping sweep, and that's going to be it. You will be able to figure out which hosts are alive, perform detailed analysis of those particular hosts, and you can see I'm already receiving information here. It says port 21, that's not the best of ideas, but this is my home router that I'm using for these testing purposes. It is filled with holes, and don't worry about it. I'm going to switch it as soon as I'm done with the tutorial. I have 443 on 102, so I probably have some SSL going on there. Port 80 here, port 23. We will soon see what all these services mean. However, you can experience these flags here, and usually you will get them. Delays because, you know, there are some packets that are being dropped, some that are being refused by the servers on the other side. You can also have time limiters and so on and so forth. So here you can see scans and what they have revealed thus far. They have given me detailed scans, and they can tell me pretty much everything that I want to know in regard to the local area network. It even gives out the MAC addresses, which I'm going to cover up and you won't be able to see them. But in any case, you see how much information do you get and how much time you can save. Now, I am going to call the tutorial here and we will move on to the next one. I hope that you've enjoyed this one, and I'll see you next time.